I want to add a 1 terabyte hard drive to my workstation that I took off a laptop. This is a Cooler Master MC500 case, and it allows for the installation of an SSD card here, here, or behind the motherboard backplane. Before I can install the hard drive, I have to look at the SATA connections and see which are available. Because I'm using 2 NVMe SSDs, these connections here and here are not available to me. This one and this one is. This already has 2 SATA cables going into it. This one only has 1. So what I need to do is just plug my new hard drive into the available port here. The existing blue SATA cable has a 90 degree connector on it, which was blocking the available port below it. So instead, we're just going to use 2 new SATA cables that are straight through, so that way we can access both the upper and lower ports with each of the new cables. With the bottom cable already installed, I go in, it's clip side up, and we insert the second SATA cable, make sure it clicks, and now we can connect these ends to the appropriate devices. I route my SATA cable out to the side of the computer. I have a port that's underneath the motherboard that gives me access to this SSD holder, so all I have to do is unscrew this, mount my hard drive to this caddy, and the cable will come right here. I could have also taken the cover and mounted it here, thus placing the hard drive out of sight, but I prefer having a nice consistent look with the 2 covers in this area. To mount the drive to the Cooler Master caddy, all we do is flip it over. There are 4 screws there. You're gonna put 4 screws here. The terminals are gonna go that way. So you simply slide it into place. It's a tension grip here, so it's really not gonna go anywhere. And you'll need to find 4 screws to secure the drive to this case. It's times like this that you're thankful you held on to those old computer screws. While we have a SATA connector here, we don't have any power, and all the power cables are being utilized for all the other drives, so which means I have to find another connection off the power supply. Fortunately, I did keep all the leftover cables from my installation, so I have a SATA power cable that will fit here, and then I can use one of these coming behind to power this drive. With the power cable routed through and our SATA cable, all we have to do is make our connection to the back connectors of the hard drive. And the cables are keyed so they only fit one way. After the connections are made, you put on the caddy, thumb screw tightens it down, and you're all set to put your glass or metal slides back on and turn on the computer. After starting up the computer, we launch disk management. And here we see NAR archive. It's our terabyte drive. And the reason I took that drive off the laptop and put it here is because it spins at 7,000 RPM. So it's actually not a slow drive as far as spinning drives go. So it will come in handy in our workstation. If you found this video interesting or useful, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, join the subscription team. And as always, thank you ever so much for watching.